morning, man. How you doing?
Doing great, Bishop. How about yourself?
Good to have you here.
Amen. Amen. Blessed to be here. Thank you for having me.
So tell us a little bit about your ministry, a little bit about your church before we get started.
Our church is in Littleton, North Carolina. It's called Kingdom Citizens Christian Center. Again, as you already stated, Bishop, it's a multicultural church. And we believe that the foundation of the church should be the people should be able to experience the love of God, the word of God, and the power of God. And, you know, I teach them every time we go and have service together that if you get 2 out of 3, you're doing okay. But I believe we should expect all 3 every time.
Can you repeat that? Did you hear what the man of God just said? Repeat the 3 things you just said about your ministry.
The 3 things that you should look for in every ministry that you go into is the love of God, the word of God, and the power of God. If the word has been preached, then the love should be present. And if the love and the word are present, then the power will just show up.
So if you've got a lot of power, but you don't have any love,
there you go.
You're in trouble, ain't you?
You're absolutely in trouble.
In fact, I think Jesus said something about that, didn't he?
He absolutely did.
He said something about, if you did miracles in your name, Jesus, and heal the sick, he said, I never knew you.
I never knew you. I absolutely never knew you. So we got to have all 3 in operation. It's a very powerful ministry. We're growing by leaps and bounds. God is just doing some wonderful things for us.
Well, we've had some good services. You've had me out there to preach for you.
And, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And you're now here to preach for us on our show. Amen. We're excited.
Amen.
You know, I really feel that we need to contrast kind of between kingdom versus religion.
Absolutely.
You know, a lot of people are in religion, and they don't, when you say the word kingdom, they're like, what do you mean kingdom?
Sure.
Can you explain the difference, or maybe in your teaching, what you explain to your members?
Well, Bishop, I think you're absolutely right. There is a great difference between our religion and kingdom. We all know that in the Greek, the kingdom is basilica. And it really is the dominion of God in the hearts of men. In other words, when you come into the kingdom of God, it's bigger than just getting saved. You know, we get 2 people to the altar, amen, and we get them saved. But I believe that when we come into the kingdom, the dominion of God comes into our lives, and then we understand that his covenant power is released to us. And not only do we get saved, now we go out into the world and we begin to walk in dominion. So that's what it means to have the kingdom.
So my understanding is that Jesus didn't come to bring a religion. A lot of people say that.
That's right. That was never his name.
His first message was, the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Exactly.
Talk a little bit about that.
Exactly right. He said the kingdom, the dominion, the power, the breakthrough, our delivering power of God is now available to those who will come into the kingdom. You know, the scripture says we've been translated out of the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his son. That lets us know that when the kingdom is present in our lives, Bishop, that we have power from another land. We have backup from another land. We, you know, Bishop, I can tell that you are not from Carolina by hearing how you speak. I can tell that you got a little New York
swag.
Where do you think I'm from? Well, you got a little New York swag. And so by the way that you carry yourself and by the way that you speak, I can tell that you're from another kingdom. You're from another government. You're from another culture. And I believe that when we get saved, God, he came to birth us into another culture and show us how that kingdom
operates. Ooh, that's good. Let me just get on this. You just said, he said we're birthing another culture.
That's it.
Because kingdoms have their own culture. And so what I see a lot of believers doing is being more loyal to their own culture than they are the culture of the kingdom. What's the culture of the kingdom like? We've got to admit you're going to go to a song, but just tell us.
Well, the culture of the kingdom is whatever there is in heaven, it should be on the earth. You know, when Jesus prayed, he didn't pray for us to get to heaven. He said, let your kingdom come and your will be done on earth, even as it is in heaven. So the culture of the kingdom is simply this, Bishop, that if there is no sickness in heaven, there should be no sickness in the earth.
Come on.
There is no lack in heaven, should be no lack in the earth. But we as God's people have a mandate on us to bring and release the kingdom that is in the heavenly places into the earth realm.
So you're saying whatever's up there,
yes,
needs to be down here. If there's no tears in heaven, there's supposed to be no crying and sadness here. Come on. Jesus said, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So what he said, whatever's up here, I want down on.
That's what his intention was.
And so is that what the church is called to do?
That's exactly right, Bishop. I think that's one thing that the churches have missed. I think we have to realize that in this hour, God has mandated his people not just to have church as usual, but to literally affect the place where he has deposited them. With his dominion in the earth realm, we have power over sickness, over lack. You know, a lot of people don't like that prosperity message. You'll make some enemies with that one. But when the kingdom shows up, there is no lack among God's people.
So when we're talking about the kingdom, we're talking about power. and we're going to be back in just a minute. We're going to go to a song, and we're going to talk a little bit more about the power of God. Amen. We'll be back in just a minute. Thank you, God.